solidarity, not just to Tony, but indeed to Larry and the wider Taylor clan. I want to say from the outset that it's extremely, I'm extremely proud to be the MP for this city and standing here with you all today in solidarity with Tony and calling once again for the immediate release of Tony Taylor. Let's be very clear on this issue. This issue is clearly a humanitarian issue. It's a blatant abuse of power by the British government and the denial of basic human rights and due process. And as we gather here this afternoon in solidarity with Lorraine and the Taylor family, I want to say once again that it is an out-and-out disgrace that we are standing here today, 2 years after the fact that Tony Taylor has been returned to McGavery Prison in circumstances that effectively amount to internment. The detention of Tony is an issue which has united many across this city. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate the committee and in particular, please give a huge round of applause to Lorraine, who has led the campaign for the past 2 years. As you can see, it's very difficult for anyone to hold together a campaign, but she's done so in dignity and, as has already been said, there are many different people from parts of our society who are here united today for Tony and indeed for Lorraine. I and Sinn Féin have repeatedly called on successive British Secretary of States to use their influence and indeed I have spoken directly to Theresa May to ask that she corrects the unjust decision of Theresa Villiers to imprison Tony. Our message today is as clear as it was 2 years ago. If Tony has questions to answer, put them before a jury and get them to answer them. Tony must be afforded the right to due process before the law. He cannot be held at the whim of a British Secretary of State without any evidence or charges being put towards him. I will be meeting Karen Bradley in the coming weeks, and again, I will use that opportunity to put forward the case of Tony Taylor and express our concerns, the concerns of the people of Derry and the people of Ireland in relation to his case. In September last year, I led a delegation alongside Raymond McCartney, Martina Anderson and the Mayor of this city directly to McGavery to speak with Tony and show support.
At that time, it was made clear to me by Tony himself
that he was being detained on probability and not facts or evidence. This is wrong and is an affront on democracy and the judicial system in this island. Sinn Féin have consistently raised Tony's wrongful detention here in Derry, Dublin, Belfast, London or Brussels. We will continue to call for Tony's release at every opportunity until he is free. I want to take this opportunity to thank Lorraine and again the committee.